Good morning, everybody. Please all stand for the Novena prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You are all beautiful Mary, and the original stain is not in you. You are the glory of Jerusalem. You are the joy of Israel. You give honor to our people. You are advocate of sinners. O Mary, Virgin most prudent, Mother most merciful, pray for us, intercede for us with the Lord Jesus Christ. O God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that you preserve her from every stain by virtue of the death of the Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleaned and admitted to your presence. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Novena prayer. Please all kneel.
Hindi ako makapag-kneel.
O most pure Virgin Mary, conceived without sin, from the very first instant, you were entirely immaculate. O glorious Mary, full of grace, you are the Mother of God, the Queen of angels and of men. I humbly venerate you as the chosen mother of my Savior Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace and the Lord of Lords. Choose you for the singular grace and honor of being his beloved mother. By the power of his cross, he preserve you from all sin. Therefore, by his power and love, I have hope and bold confidence in your prayers for my holiness and salvation. I pray that your prayers will bring me to imitate your holiness and submission to Jesus and the divine will. Queen of heaven, I beg you to beg my Savior to grant me this request. My Holy Mother, I know that you were obedient to the will of God. In making the petition, I know that God's will is more perfect than mine. So grant us,
may you receive God's grace with humility as you did.
As my final request, I ask that you pray for me to increase in faith in our risen Lord. I ask that you pray for me to increase in hope in our risen Lord. I ask that you pray for me to increase in love for the risen Jesus. Amen. Day 8. Seek the Lord while he may found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way, the sinners their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord to find mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways. For as the heaven are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. Eighth day, O Blessed Virgin, to intercessor and benefactress before the throne of God, now that the end of this novena is near, I implore and I ask you that your most holy will be realized in my life. I truly repent all of my sins, and I will confess them all that I may become worthy of your grace, especially the grace to be with you in heaven forever. Through your intercession, O Mother, may I always obey the laws of God and of Mother Church. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Mother of Christ,
pray for us.
Mother of Church,
pray for us.
Mother of Mercy,
pray for us.
Mother of Divine Grace,
pray for us.
Mother of Hope,
pray for us.
Mother Most Pure,
pray for us.
Mother Most Chaste,
pray for us.
Mother Inviolate,
pray for us.
Mother Undefiled,
pray for us.
Mother Most Amiable,
pray for us.
Mother Most Admirable,
pray for us.
Mother of Good Counsel,
pray for us.
Mother of Our Creator,
pray for us.
Mother of Our Savior,
pray for us.
You are all beautiful.
Virgin most prudent, Virgin most venerable, Virgin most renowned, Virgin most powerful,
pray for us.
Virgin most merciful,
pray for us.
Virgin most faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of justice,
pray for us.
Seat of wisdom,
pray for us.
Cause of our joy,
pray for us.
Spiritual vessel,
pray for us.
Vessel of honor,
pray for us.
Singular vessel of devotion,
pray for us.
Mystical rose,
pray for us.
Tower of David,
pray for us.
Tower of ivory,
pray for us.
House of gold,
pray for us.
Ark of the covenant,
pray for us.
Gate of heaven,
pray for us.
Morning star,
pray for us.
Health of the sick,
pray for us.
Refuge of sinners,
pray for us.
Solace of migrants,
pray for us.
Comforter of the afflicted,
pray for us.
Help of Christian,
pray for us.
Queen of angels,
pray for us.
Queen of patriarchs,
pray for us.
Queen of prophets,
pray for us.
Queen of apostles,
pray for us.
Queen of martyrs,
pray for us.
Queen of confessors,
pray for us.
Queen of virgins,
pray for us.
Queen of all saints,
pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us.
Queen assumed in heaven,
pray for us.
Queen of the most holy rosary,
pray for us.
Queen of families,
pray for us.
Queen of peace,
pray for us.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Da memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercessions, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother, to you do I come. Before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful, O Mother of the world incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer me. Amen. Pope Francis' prayer to Mary Immaculate. Virgin most holy and immaculate,
to you the honor of our people and our loving protector.
Do we return with loving trust. You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you there is no sin. Awaken in all of us renewed desire for holiness. May the splendor of truth shine forth in our words. The song of charity resound in our work. Purity and chastity abide in our hearts and bodies. and the full beauty of gospel be evident in our lives. You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you the Word of God became flesh. Help us always to hear the Lord's voice. May we never be indifferent to the cry of the poor, or untouched by the sufferings of the sick and those in need. May we be sensitive to the holiness of the elderly and the vulnerability of children, and always love and cherish the life of every human being. You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you, in the fullness of joy, born of life with God. Help us never to forget the meaning of our earthly journey. May the kindly light of faith illumine our days. The comforting power of hope direct our steps. The contagious warmth of love steer our hearts. And may your gaze be fixed on God, in whom true joy is found. You are most all beautiful, O Mary. Hear our prayer. Graciously hear our prayer. May the beauty of God's merciful love in Jesus abide in our hearts. And may we divine beauty save us, our city, and the entire world. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, on this eighth day of the novena to the Immaculate Conception, we lift up to God our prayer intentions, especially our prayers for those who are sick and for those who need our prayers the most. Let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who made the Bishop Saint Ambrose a teacher of the Catholic faith and a model of apostolic courage, raise up in your church men after your own heart to govern her with courage and wisdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, O people of Zion, who dwell in Jerusalem, no more will you weep. He will be gracious to you when you cry out. As soon as he hears, he will answer you. The Lord will give you the bread you need and the water for which you thirst. No longer will your teacher hide himself, but with your own eyes you shall see your teacher. While from behind a voice shall sound in your ears, this is the way, walk in it. When you would turn to the right or to the left, he will give rain for the seed that you sow in the ground, and the wheat that you sow produces will be rich and abundant. On that day, your flock will be given pastures. The lamb will graze in spacious meadows, the oxen and the asses that till the ground will eat silage tossed to them with shovel and pitchfork. Upon every high mountain and lofty hill, there will be streams of running water. On the day of the great slaughter, when the towers fall, the light of the moon will be like that of the sun, and the light of the sun will be seven times greater, like the light of 7 days. On the day the Lord binds up the wounds of his people, he will heal the bruises left by his blows. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are all who wait for the Lord.
Blessed are all who wait for the Lord.
Praise the Lord, for he is good. Sing praise to our God, for he is gracious. It is fitting to praise him. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. The dispersed of Israel he gathers.
Blessed are all who wait for the Lord.
He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He tells the numbers of the stars. He calls each by name.
Blessed are all who wait for the Lord.
Great is our Lord and mighty in power. To him, wisdom, there is no limit. The Lord sustains the lowly. The wicked he casts to the ground.
Blessed are all who wait for the Lord. Please all stand.
The Lord is our judge, our lawgiver, our king. He it is who will save us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went around to all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and curing every disease and illness. At the sight of the crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them, because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest." Then he summoned his disciples, his 12 disciples, and gave them authority over unclean spirits to drive them out and to cure every disease and every illness. Jesus sent out these 12 after instructing them thus, "Go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go, make this proclamation: the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse lepers, drive out demons. Without cost you have received, without cost you are to give." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. And greetings also to those who are joining us in this celebration through live streaming. No? First of all, I would like to thank Monsignor Rolly and Father Viel, no, for inviting me to celebrate the 8th day of our novena as we prepare for the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. And I think it is fitting that the theme of our gospel for today has to do with mission. Our gospel is quite clear on this call for mission, a call to follow the Lord and to be sent on mission. Yung gospel po natin ngayon, medyo explicit and direct. Sabi nga ng iba, parang self-explanatory, no? Alam mo na agad yung ibig ituro sa atin ng Ebanghelyo. The Lord is saying, the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. The Lord, who is calling us to serve Him and to follow Him, is telling us there's a need for laborers for the harvest. Kailangan ng mga manggagawa sa anihan. To be on mission does not just refer to priestly or religious life. Madalas po kasi iyan ang na-identify natin. Ah, mission daw, mission. Para yan sa mga pari at para sa mga madre. But there's a lot of work to be done in the vineyard of the Lord. At hindi yan kakayanin ng pari at madre lamang. Kaya nga, ang misyon ay para sa ating lahat. We all have a task to carry out, to fulfill this mission. Ang tanong po, una, are we willing to respond? At pangalawa, are we prepared to respond? Handa ba tayo at kaya ba nating tumugon sa tawag na ito na mag-mission? Note that the Lord's call to serve or the call to the ministry is rooted from His deep compassion. Doon nakaugat ang mission ni Jesus, compassion. Yun daw pong compassion galing sa dalawang salita, no? Cum and passio, no? Yung cum ay with at yung passio ay to suffer. So to suffer with. Handa ka bang magdusa kasama ang iba? Handa ka bang sumama sa pagtitiis ng iba? Kasi ang sabi po sa gospel, at the sight of the crowds, His heart was moved with pity for them because they were troubled and abandoned like sheep without a shepherd. Doon na antig ang damdamin ni Jesus. And so anyone who responds to the call of the Lord and enters into ministry, into a life of service, must also begin with compassion, with concern, with love. Ang tunay na naghahangad na maglingkod, magsisimula muna sa kakayanang magmahal at sumabay sa pinagdaraanan ng kanyang kapwa. And this is precisely what the laborers must bring to the harvest. This is precisely what the disciples of the Lord must bring to the ministry. Compassion, love. Baliwala ang oras mo sa paglilingkod kung hindi ito nagsisimula sa compassion and love for other people. In other words, part of our mission is to become instruments of the Lord's compassion, mercy, and love. Yun pala ang bahagi ng ating pagnanais na maglingkod. Kaya ang tanong natin, paano ko magagawa ang misyon na ito? Kung hindi naman ako karapat-dapat, madalas pumapasok sa ating kalooban yan. Kaya kapag may ia-assign ka sa simbahan, maging leader ng ganitong grupo, o maging bahagi ng ganitong organization, ang sasabihin agad ng iba, parang hindi po ako worthy. Parang hindi po ako karapat-dapat dyan. We all feel that we are not worthy to respond to this mission. Mary, the Mother of God, stands for us as a model for mission. Her life reflects perfect discipleship, which is grounded in humility, grounded in faith, and grounded in obedience to God's will. Kaya kung misyon ang pinag-uusapan, hindi na tayo titingin sa kung kani-kanino pa, kay Maria na lamang. Just as Jesus sends out His disciples to carry out the mission of the kingdom, Mary, the Immaculate Conception, exemplifies what it means to embrace and to respond to God's call. Sa kanya natin yun makikita. And the gospel today highlights the heart of mission. Ano ba ang puso ng mission? At sabi nga po natin, it flows from compassion, is rooted in service, and is dependent on God's authority and grace. Mary embodies all these traits. Her compassion is evident in her concern for Elizabeth, leading her to the hill country to serve her cousin. Number two, her service is seen in her willingness to endure misunderstandings and hardships as the chosen mother of the Savior. And lastly, her dependence on God's authority is clear in her trust that God would fulfill His promises. Compassion, rootedness in service, dependence on God's authority and grace. As we reflect on this gospel passage in the light of Mary, we are reminded that mission is not reserved for a select few. Hindi nga pala ito para sa mga pari lamang o para sa mga madre lamang. Like Mary and the disciples, we are called to proclaim the kingdom of God in our own lives. Mary teaches us that mission begins in our hearts when we say yes to God. From there, it extends to others as we become instruments of His love, compassion, and healing. My dear brothers and sisters, on this eighth day of our novena, Mary invites us to trust in God's plan, even when the mission seems unclear. Minsan parang nalalabuan tayo, ano ba ang gustong ipagawa talaga sa akin ng Diyos? Ano ba ang gusto ng Diyos? Bakit ba niya ako dinala dito sa simbahan? Bakit niya ba ako pina-appoint na maging officer ng ganitong samahan? Ano ba talaga hindi ko maintindihan? At hindi po kayo nag-iisa sa ganyang pakiramdam. Kung minsan po, kaming mga pari din, bakit ba ako inassign dito? Ano bang maiko-contribute ko sa community na ito? Bakit ba ako in-appoint sa ganitong posisyon? So yung pagdududa at pagtatanong, yung kalabuan ng misyon, lahat po tayo makakaugnay dyan. Lahat tayo dumadaan sa ganyang pagtatanong. Mary also reminds us to rely on grace, knowing that the one who calls us will equip us for the task. In this Advent season, as we prepare to celebrate the coming of Christ, may we follow Mary's example of faith-filled mission, bringing the light of Christ to a world in need of hope and healing. Nawa, katulad ni Maria, bawat isa po sa atin maging instrumento ng Panginoon upang maiparating sa kapwa ang kanyang pag-ibig at malasakit. Amen.
Please all stand.
God the Father has invited us to be His ministers to spread the good news of salvation. We pray for the grace to recognize the dignity of our mission and the necessary strength to carry it out. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Does the Pilgrim Church may inspire people to renew their lives by faithfully bearing witness to Christ in word and in deed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That missionaries in foreign lands may be effective in bringing the gospel of salvation to all they meet by their witness of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That parents may communicate their faith to their children by the holiness of their life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick, the elderly, the handicapped, the lonely, and brokenhearted may feel the love of Christ through the care of their families and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may enjoy everlasting peace in God's presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, guide our faltering steps as we walk on your path. Help us in our struggle, encourage us in our doubts, comfort us in our pain. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we celebrate the divine mysteries, O Lord, we pray, may the Holy Spirit fill us with the light of faith, by which He constantly enlightened Saint Ambrose for the spreading of your glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Ambrose, you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Ambrose and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Salamat sa kanyang paghahari, sa kanyang magdating, iwan ang buhay, ang
Please stand.
Let us pray. Lead us who have been strengthened by the power of this sacrament, O Lord, so to profit from the teaching of Saint Ambrose, that hastening fearlessly along your paths, we may be prepared for the delights of the eternal banquet through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Good morning. Before the final blessing, I would like to take this opportunity to thank all of you for joining us on this eighth day of the 9-day novena in honor of Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception. In particular, I would like to thank the CWL, the officers and members of the different CWL units within the diocese. Every first Saturday, they are having Mass here in one of the chapels, but they decided to join the bigger community as we prepare for this fiesta. And I would like to ask to thank Father Eric, our celebrant, Eric Castro, our main presider over the Eucharist on this eighth day of the novena. He is the rector and parish priest of the National Shrine of Sacred Heart in Makati. So thank you, Father Eric, for giving us time. No? He is also celebrating his silver jubilee this year. And as a token of our appreciation, kindly accept this image, a replica of the image of Our Lady enshrined at the sanctuary. Tomorrow, our Masses would be 8 and 10 in the morning, and the 10 o'clock in the morning will be the Novena Mass, the ninth Novena Mass, and you are also invited. And in the evening, the Mass will be at 6 p.m. And after the Mass will be the procession of three images around Intramuros. So the Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Charles Brown, will preside over the 6 p.m. Mass tomorrow. And hopefully you join us also in the procession. Kindly bring your candles. Maikli lang naman po, palibot lang ng Intramuros. And on Monday, December 9, will be the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. And the Masses here will be at 7:30 in the morning, 12:10 in the afternoon, and 6 p.m. Mamili na po kayo kung saan ninyo gustong magsimba. And hopefully, the Lord will give us fine weather in these coming days. So muli po, maraming salamat sa inyong pagdalo.
Please, the Lord be with you.
And with yours.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, Ina.